Hello, hello, I'm Li Hao. Today we're going to talk about each logic block. In this example, I have a list of colors, and I want to show all the colors in a list. So what I do is, I come over here, I create one list item by one by one. So I show like the colors, I use index to get the first color, the second color, and the third color. But when I need to add another color, say I want to add yellow, then I have to come over here, copy and paste, change this to 3 and to show like the fourth color. So is there a way to reduce this so that we can just write it once and some way to loop through all the colors and display it on the screen? Well, there is. Right? That's the point of this example that I want to show you is there is a better way of doing this, which is to use the each logic block. So before we go dive into the each block, I'm going to draw a comparison from JavaScript on how you would loop through a list of colors and do something with it. Right? So we're going to compare that with our each logic block so that you can see the similarities so that you can draw the connection between them. Okay, so over here, if I'm gonna loop through the colors, usually there's a few ways I can use arrays.forEach, right? I can use arrays.forEach. I could use a for loop with an index to loop through loop through all the colors, but my favorite is if I just want to get the colors, I don't care about the index, I would use for cons of loop, which is for color of colors. For of loop, right? So in this for of loop, on every iteration, what I get is the color. So in this example, I'm gonna just console out what is in the color. And you can see from the console, there's red, green, blue, and yellow. So every iteration, I print out that color at this point of time, right? So the same thing goes with the each logic block. To start the each block, so I think I give a big hint for you. The block name is called each, and we've learned previously how to start a block. You start with coming with a curly brackets and a hash sign, and then the name of the logic block, right? So we're gonna use each logic block. So we're gonna type each, and before we type further, the way we end it is to come over here, slash each, right? You start with a hash and you end with a slash. So how do you loop through an array using an each logic blocks? Well, it's kind of a bit inverse of how you do with a for of loop, right? You start with the arrays, the name of the arrays first. So each of the colors, and then you use s. So each s instead of for of, right? So for each of the colors as a variable, so I'm gonna say color. So over here, I have access to the color. So you can see this is kind of like inverted, right? You for item of an array and you each the array as the item. So in each of this content over here, you can treat it as each iteration, what you are going to show for each of the iteration. So for each of the iteration, I'm going to show a list item, which is this one. So I'm going to copy, come over here and paste it in. And I'm going to use the color that in the current iteration, so which is the color variable, right? So now I can remove this. And you can see immediately that red, green, blue, yellow is how I would iterate through. I print out red, green, blue, yellow. I use each block, it will iterate through all the colors and it will show in order red, green, blue, and yellow. All right, so that is how you use a each logic block. So let's move on to the next thing. All right, so over here right now, I'm going to change a bit on my array. I'm going to come over here and change slightly to include do not just use a string, but an object, because so that, you know, in each item, I can not just telling you what is the name of the color. I will also tells you like what's the hex representation of the number, of the color. So for red is F00. For green, it's zero. Green, blue, F0. For blue, it's gonna be red, green, blue. So 00F. And for yellow, this is a tricky one. I don't really know the hex of a yellow color. I'm guessing it's gonna be red, green, blue. Green and blue? 0FF? I'm just gonna guess, but let's see how it is. Right, so we have a list of colors, which is object, and you have a name and a hex. Right, as you can see here, we are consoling our object, and if we show an object directly on the screen, you're just gonna see the string representation of it, right? You just cast it into a string, right? It will be similar as you call string with the color. This is the same thing. But what we want instead is maybe for now, we're just gonna show the color, the object itself. So I'm gonna use json.stringify so that you can see the resemblance of this in the console and this in the screen. So with a for loop, sometimes I'm gonna cheat a bit. Instead of let's not do the cheat first. Right, so if I want to access the name of the color, I will come here and say color.name. Right, again, I get all the colors, and I can get color.hex. I get all the hexa representation of color. So the same thing goes. I can come over here and say color.name. Right, again, I go see red, green, blue, yellow, and I'm gonna add a style by color the item with the hex, right? So I'm gonna say color, and then color.hex. Really, okay, so this is definitely not yellow. I can't remember what's the yellow. Oh yeah, okay, FF0. FF0 will be yellow. So this, I will style the item with the hex of the, using color.hex and color.name, right? Same way how you would access it using a for loop. But sometimes I'm getting lazy, right? Getting lazy. That's why I'm going for, because sometimes I am lazy and I know that I don't really need the color. I want to destructure immediately of this array. So how do you do destructuring? Right? Destructuring, you can destructure it like this, and you can name out the properties of the item, right? So previously we have color. Right, color has two properties, name and hex. So I'm going to say name and hex, so I can use it directly from here. Right, as you can see, again in the console, you console out red and the hex value in each iteration. So can I do destructuring over here as well? Well, yes, you can. So I'm going to destructure. So I am lazy to type. I'm just going to copy this and paste it over here. So now I have name and hex. To use it, I will replace this with a hex, and this is name. And again, nothing's changed, but we have changed our code. So this shows that this, what we've written previously and what we're writing now is the same, right? You can do this. You can destructure directly in the each logic block, and it will work. So if I come over here, if I want to add another color, name equals black. This color itself does not have any hex value. So you can see if you print out, it's called undefined because you don't have any hex value. So if you inspect over here, you probably will see that the style color will be undefined. So sometimes you have that. What happens is that you want to have fallback, right? You fallback to some other things. Over here, I'm gonna just say purple, just so that it's obvious, right? So the fallback for this is you can do it this way, right? You fall back to a purple color. But this is falling back on the usage of hex, right? When you want to use the hexadecimal representation, you want to use it, you say, okay, if it's defined, yes, show me this value. If not, fall back to purple. But what if you want to provide like some sort of default value when you're declaring the variable hex over here, right? Here we are declaring name and hex in a destructuring way. And we can provide a default value by say hex equals to purple like this. So what it means is that if I remove this, if hex is not defined, it will be purple, right? So black, you have a hex called purple. So how do you do this over here? You can do it the same way. So I'm going to just copy. So to show that it's the same thing, come over here and I can remove this. You can see immediately again, it's showing purple color, right? Nothing's changed because it works. Because it works, that's why nothing has changed. So here you can see we are drawing very closely to the for cons of loop with the each logic block, except that you start with for the item of the array, but in each you use the each of the array as item. So anything over here, you can write anything that you write over here can be just copy over and paste it in over here, and it will work as you would expect. And whatever inside the content will be evaluated on every iteration of the loop, just like how you would do something at every iteration within this block. So you have access to name and hex the same way as here, as the for loop, right? So, and as of the for loop, you can nest it, right? So I will come over here, and because I'm lazy to come up with arrays, I'm going to loop through the hex string itself. So I'm going to say a character of hex. So if I console log, you'll see that it will loop through all the characters of the hex. Right, so same thing over here. If I can come over here and add this block, but I need to write as each block, right? So I'm going to say each. And we copy the array first as, and then the item. Every time when you start, you need to close it. So I'm going to come here and I'm going to close the block. And what are we going to do in between? Okay, what are we going to do in between is we're going to create more items, right? Because I am lame and can't think of anything. So I'm going to say character. And you can see you are looping through all the characters of the hexadecimal representation of the color. So you can see we draw a very close comparison with the for off loop with the Svelte logic, each logic block. So if you have any questions, feel free to comment down below. And as always, click like if you like this video. If you learn a lot, spam the like button. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel so that you get notified when the next one is out. So see ya, bye bye.